Hello everyone. In our previous episode, we saw how the big clans of Uesugi, Hosokawa and Shimazu fractured from the inside, falling in civil war. And also the expansion of the Hojo clan in the Kanto plain, showing their thirst for power. In this episode, we'll see the rise of Takeda Shingen, one of the legendary samurai leaders that shaped the history of Japan. Takeda clan ruled over the province of Kai. The leader of Takeda clan in 1520 was Takeda Nobutora, that in the past years have frequently entered in conflict with the neighboring clans of Hojo, Imagawa, and also with the many lesser clans ruling the Shinano province to the north. But all the conflicts ended in just skirmishes with no real gain. In 1531, a coalition of clans from Shinano have endured enough and decided to march on Takeda. But the coalition was short-lived. Takeda stood strong and the battle ended in a clear Takeda victory. In 1535, another threat appeared on the horizon, a combined attack from the Hojo and Imagawa. Normally, Takeda would face doom in front of a combined attack of such large and powerful clans. But something unexpected happened. Uesugi Tomooki, the leader of the Ogigatsu Uesugi clan, was marching into Hojo to take its revenge from the Hojo Ujitsuna. Ujitsuna was forced to retreat from Kai to defend against Tomooki. So Imagawa was now left to face alone the Takeda. This battle will expand into a war that will last for 1 year, ending when the Imagawa leader died of an illness without naming a heir. Immediately, his brothers that were living as monks returned home to gather forces and fight one against the other for the control of the clan, throwing it into a civil war known as the Hanagura Disturbance. One of the brothers, Imagawa Yoshimoto, was the legitimate heir and had every right to be the next daimyo, while the other one, a half-brother, Genko Etan, attracted followers due to the fact that he was the older of the two and that his mother was originating from a prestigious family. Nobutora and Ujitsuna both will ally with Imagawa Yoshimoto, helping him with the war against his half-brother and reunite the fractured clan. Looking to strengthen this bond, Nobutora sent his eldest daughter to marry Yoshimoto. This new alliance infuriated Ujitsuna and led to open war between Imagawa and Hojo as Hojo launched attacks in the Sugura province. As Hojo and Imagawa started fighting, Nobutora turned his attention to invading the Shinano province. In November of 1536, Nobutora sieged the fortress of Unokuchi alongside with his son that just came of age, Takeda Harunobu, that will later be known as the legendary Takeda Shingen. But right now, he was just a boy who had never seen war. Takeda forces laid siege on Unokuchi for 34 days. Yet, as the defenders held firm, Nobutora's determination began to fade, and as the winter set in, he ordered the withdrawal back to Kai. Harunobu was eager to prove himself, so early one morning, he ordered his men to break off from the rest of the marching army and to return back to Unokuchi. There, he found out that the defending army have completely dispersed, believing that the Takeda have been long gone, so they only left 100 men in the castle. Harunobu decided to split his forces in three. One led the siege and two were waiting outside hiding. This way, he fooled the defending men who could not determine how large the attacking force was. This led to the fall of Unokuchi and Takeda Harunobu's first victory. He will return to his father with the head of the commander of Unokuchi Castle. However, instead of praising him, Nobutora scolded him for the stupidity of his actions and for not respecting the orders. It is said that this was only because his older brother Takeda Nobushige was often seen as Nobutora's favorite son and most likely the one who'd be chosen as the heir of the clan. However, even if Nobutora refused to celebrate his son's heroic deed, in secret, many of the Takeda commanders admired Harunobu's actions. Meanwhile, Hojo Uchitsuna continued his aggressive campaign in the Kanto Plain by clashing with the Imagawa in the Sugura province. Later, in 1537, Tomooki died, opening a new opportunity for Uchitsuna. Thus, he turned his attention once again to the north, attacking the Ogigeatsu Uesugi at the Kawagoe Castle. The battle was short. Uesugi had no chance against the overwhelming united Hojo army. After this battle, Hojo gained most of the Musashi region. This success, though, infuriated the neighboring Koga clan, that knew they will be the next target. Thus, decided to ally with the Satomi and confront the Hojo army. In 1538, the confrontation took place outside the Konodai castle. This will be the first epic clash of the Sengoku Jidai, the epic battle of Konodai. Hojo gathered 20,000 soldiers, while the combined forces of Satomi and Koga numbered 10,000. At the start of the battle was harsh, but slowly the Hojo army started to engulf the enemy forces due to the bigger army. Satomi began to break and rout while Koga forces stand their ground. Koga Daimyo's son, Motoyori, personally slayed 30 Hojo samurai before finally being killed. A messenger delivered the news to the Koga Daimyo that his son had been killed, making him burst in rage and leading a final mad attack. This also inspired his forces and for a moment Koga forces managed to shatter the Hojo momentum and to push them back. But when Koga Daimyo stopped for a moment to catch his breath, a Hojo archer recognized him and put an arrow in his chest, killing him and causing Koga forces to break. Hojo have won the battle. Ujitsuna will take control over Konodai Castle and will pursue further south to catch the routing forces of Satomi. In 5041, after 3 more years, Ujitsuna will finally die and leave a legacy as legendary as his father's. He will be replaced by his son, Hojo Ujiatsu, who will one day come to be known as the Lion of Sagami. In the next episode, we will witness another major battle taking place back in the West. Thanks for watching and hope you enjoy. See you in the next episode.